There are many important landmark features on the ventral aspect of brainstem and hypothalamus. Caudally, the midline in the medulla is established by the anterior median fissure. Adjacent to it, on either side, the medullary pyramid. The pyramids contain the pyramidal or corticospinal tracts. Dorsolateral to the pyramid is the olive of the medulla. The pre- and post-olivary sulci are shown as cranial nerve root attachment sites. Observe the division between the medulla and the pons as the pontomedullary sulcus running transversely. We have just entered the ventral aspect or base of the pons. The corticobulbar and corticospinal tracts, the transverse fibers of the pons, and the pontine nuclei make the base large. Retracting the basilar artery reveals the basilar sulcus underneath. The base of the pons ends at the interpeduncular fossa, which signifies the base of the midbrain between the two cerebral peduncles. This is also the site of the posterior perforated substance and the attachment of the oculomotor nerve roots. On either side, we can now see the cerebral peduncles, these massive conduits for the descending corticospinal and corticobulbar tracts inside. From the midbrain, we move into the ventral aspect of hypothalamus, starting with the mammillary bodies caudally, these paired bumps. And now the midportion, the tuber cinereum of ventral hypothalamus, containing this funneling region, the infundibulum, going into the infundibular or pituitary stalk. And now the optic chiasm, more anteriorly. The two optic nerves, following the partial crossing at the chiasm, the fibers continue in the optic tract. Here is optic tract on one side.